Last night, British Columbia lost one of its greatest champions, Grace McCarthy.
She was 100% for British Columbia. And she spent her whole life, as far as I could see, doing everything she could that was good for BC.
One of the first times Jim Pattison met Grace McCarthy was at his car dealership in 1966. She was a businesswoman attempting to enter the political arena.
And she came in and wanted to borrow every convertible that we had, and we loaned them to her. And the next thing I remember her waving to me as she went by with all these convertibles, waving at the, having a little parade.
Grace won her seat as an MLA and over the next 30 years became a prominent figure in the social credit government.
I don't think that anybody could help but respect her. She carried herself with grace and dignity and power and sensitivity.
She held a variety of cabinet portfolios, became party leader, and was the first woman in Canada to become deputy minister.
Grace would take one on the jaw just like anybody else, and people noticed, and she gained stature, and then women gained stature.
When I was a little girl in Burnaby, you'd turn on the TV at the news hour every night with your family, and there were precious few women making decisions on the news, and Grace McCarthy was one of them.
The legacy of the woman known as Amazing Grace includes Expo 86.
Grace sold Bill Bennett on the idea when he was premier.
Around the same time, she launched SkyTrain, and those lights along the Lionsgate Bridge, they're called Gracie's Necklace for a reason. And when she left politics, she created and chaired the Child Foundation.
She had the ability, the desire, and the get up and go to make a difference.
Linda Aylesworth, Global News.